Governor Kate Brown announced updates to COVID-19 metrics this morning for students to return to in-person classes. She says the new metrics allow for more flexibility, and nearly 130,000 students could get back to class very soon. Alec Nolan is here with more. Alec?
That's right, Max. The new metrics could mean students returning to class before the holidays, but there's a lot of planning in the days ahead. I talked with school officials to hear about their next steps.
Despite record COVID-19 case numbers, state officials unveiled new, more flexible guidelines for returning students to classrooms.
We must begin prioritizing getting our kids back into the classroom for in-person instruction.
They noted data shows schools do not appear to be the super spreader locations many had feared. Governor Kate Brown stating that nearly 130,000 students could return to class based on the updated metrics, but the vast majority will remain at home. The new metrics are as follows. Counties that have 200 new COVID-19 cases per 100,000 people over 14 straight days will remain in distance learning. If the county has between 100 to 200 cases, that places them in the transition column. 50 to 100 cases places a county in a hybrid of on-site and distance learning, and counties with fewer than 50 cases are eligible for on-site learning. That leaves Ben Lapine schools in Deschutes County K-3 eligible. But interim superintendent Laura Nordquist is moving forward with caution.
The case counts this week, we've had 3 days in a row with case counts over around 25. So we're very concerned. We're watching those. But if we make it on Monday, we will immediately be communicating and getting our kids back into school before Thanksgiving.
The Redmond School District is in the same situation.
We'll start off with a hybrid over a week to train students how to operate in this new environment. But then after a week, we feel to bring back K-3 full time.
Perhaps the biggest critic of the new metrics is the head of the teachers union. John Larson issued a statement saying, "The governor's decision to hastily implement new relaxed metrics will only serve to further disrupt education for students, families, and educators." Many have questioned the new metrics at a time when cases are up, but state officials say these are not radical shifts, and having zero risk is not the way forward.
Crook County schools have been in session for weeks. They'll be able to open, or I should say, they will be able to remain open until at least January 4th. After that date, they'll have to adhere to these new metrics as well. Max, back to you.